Hi viewers, welcome to my channel. I'm Sanappa. So in this video we are going to see about PID control. Okay, so PID control, we will see two type of PID controlling. One is upwards or forward PID control, another is reverse or downwards PID control. Okay, like so upward PID control, that means when we are controlling a pressure, when the pressure goes beyond the set value, means below the set value, the analog output will increase and it will try to match with the set point from below value to set point value. Okay, this is one type of PID value. Another one is when this measuring value goes below the set value, that means the measuring value will be higher than the set value when it is goes below the set value. So it will try to the analog output will try to match with the set point. Okay, so this is two types of PID value. Now we will see how we can do the programming in Siemens Logo PLC. Okay, now we will start the program. Now we need one analog input. Okay, so this analog input, now we will connect a PI controller. So measuring range, now our sensor type is 0 to 10 volt. Okay, there are many sensor values available. We will select 0 to 10 volt. Our measuring range is, we will consider some 0 to 100 bar or whatever. Okay, so we will 0 to 100 bar. Okay. Now here we will see our set, we will set our set point. Now we want to maintain around 50 bar. Okay, so our measuring value is 0 to 100 bar. Now we will keep 0 to our set value is 50 bar. Okay, now here we will see. Okay, here go with user defined. Now we can, here we can select our type of PID control, upwards or downwards. Okay, so we want to maintain pressure when the pressure goes below the set point, so it should match. So that means the PID should be in upwards. Okay, so now we put upwards PID. Okay, now we will connect analog output. For PID enable, we will connect one auto switch. Okay, digital input, that means this is auto mode. Okay, when this switch is enable auto, the PID will start. Okay, now we made programming. Now we will do simulation. So our PI graph is showing. Now we have to enable our PI controller. So once I enable this PI control, our input is 0, that means the measuring pressure is 0. So the our analog output is enabled, so it is going, it is increasing the value. Okay, so it will give 0 to 10 volt or 4 to 20 milliampere based on your analog output module. So the analog output value is now increasing until the analog input value increases. Okay, so now you will give our, so now our input pressure input is, it is more than 50 bar, so 56 bar, that means the value is decreased till 0. Okay, so this is forward type or upwards type PI controller. Okay, now we will see reverse. Okay, or downwards, the same PI block, you will select downwards. Okay, once you select this downwards, the PI control will work in reverse. Okay, now you can see our set value is 50, so the value is 56, the analog output is enabled. So once this value goes below, the output value also will come 0. Once the value goes up, the analog output will enable. So this is the difference between upwards or forward PID, downwards or reverse PID. Okay, so this upward PID control is usually used in measuring or maintain the pressures. Okay, pressure or mainly pressure. The downwards or reverse PID mainly used in this HVAC system to maintain the humidity. Okay, so I hope you understand the blocks I used, the way I explained the program I made. Okay, so if you have any doubt, please let me know through comments. If you are new for my channel, please do subscribe. Okay, and I have posted many other PLC programs related to HVAC, other functions also. Okay, as Siemens as well as Schneider. Okay, so thanks for watching. I will meet you in next video. Till then, bye from Sennappa.